The problem is capital X is a continuous random variable.
The screen is not visible.
Okay, just a minute. Capital X is a continuous variable with PDF PDF means probability density function with PDF given by fx has the structure in this way. Fx is equal to kx 0 less than or equal to x less than or equal to 2, kx 0 less than or equal to x less than or equal to 2, 2k that is 2 less than or equal to x less than or equal to 4, and 6k minus kx 2 less than or equal to x less than or equal to 4 and 0 otherwise means, so that is the range is 4 less than or equal to x less than or equal to 6, that is whenever x is negative or x greater than 6, in that case the functional structure is 0. Okay, find the value of the constant k. Find the value of the constant k and also find the mean and variance of capital X. So please try to find the solution. X is a continuous random variable with probability density function given by fx having this structure. We need to find the value of the constant k and also need to find the mean and variance of the random variable capital X. Let's try to find the solution. So let us try to find the solution. So first we need to determine the value of the constant k. So for that, what you know, integration minus infinity to infinity fx dx is equal to 1. So that would give you, now this can be written as minus infinity to 0, minus infinity to 0, fx dx, 0 to 2, fx dx, 2 to 4, fx dx, 4 to 6, fx dx, 6 to infinity, fx dx is equal to 1. Now put the structure of the function in each of the interval. If we put what you will get, so this would give you minus infinity to 0, that is x is here negative, x is negative, the function structure is 0, integration of 0, that will be 0, integration 2 to 4, sorry, 0 to 2, in between 0 to 2, function structure is kx, four to six, in between four to six, the functional structure is 6k minus kx. and 6 to infinity, again the function structure is 0, integration of 0 is 0, so we need not to write that one. This implies, now let us try to find these integrations. So if we integrate, what we'll get, k into x squared by 2, 0 to 2 plus 2kx, 2k is constant, integration dx, that will be x, 2 to 4 plus, here will be integrate 6k into x minus k x squared by 2, 4 to 6, this equal to 1. Now, so try to find these integrations. So this will give you, now put the limits, what we'll get, if we put the upper limit, we'll get 2 squared, that is 4, 4 divided by 2, that will be 2k, for lower limit, that will be 0, plus, if we put the upper limit, what we'll get, 8k, minus 4k, plus, if we put the upper limit, what we'll get, 36k minus 36 by 2, that will be 18k. For formula, there will be a minus sign. Now put the lower limit, x is equal to 4, that is 24k minus minus will become plus. If we put 4, that is 4 squared is 16, 16 divided by 2, that will be 8k. This equal to 1, 2k plus 4k plus, if we simplify that, what we'll get, 36 minus 18, that will be 18, 18 plus 8, 18 plus 8 is 26, 26 minus 24, that will be 2k. So value of k is 1 by 8. So that's the value of the constant k. So after putting the value of the constant k, the structure of the function fx will become, so therefore fx becomes, first one is kx, kx means 1 by 8 into zero less than or equal to x less than or equal to 2. Then next is 2k. 2k means 2 into 1 by 8, that is 1 by 4. 2 less than or equal to x less than or equal to 4. And the next one is 6k minus kx. 6k means 6 by 8. 6 by 8 means 3 by 4. minus 1 by 8 into x, 4 less than or equal to x less than or equal to 6, and 0 elsewhere. Now find the mean of the distribution. So mean means expectation. Mean is equal to expectation of x. So that will be integration minus infinity to infinity x into fx dx. So let us put the structure of fx. So if we put the structure of fx, ultimately we'll end up with 0 to 2. X in between 0 to 2, the functional structure is 1 by 8 into x. two to four, 1 by 4 x dx. two to four, 1 by 4 into x dx plus 4 to 6 x 3 by 4 minus 1 by 8. Now integrate, 1 by 8 is coming out. Integration x multiplied with will be x squared. X squared integration is x cubed by 3, 0 to 2 plus 1 by 4. X squared by 2, 2 to 4, plus 3 by 4 into x, that will be x squared by 2 minus 1 by 8, x multiplied with that will be x squared, that is x cubed by 3, 4 to 6. Now simplify that. So 1 by 8 into 8 by 3 follow all limit, that will be 0, plus 1 by 8, 16 minus 4 plus 3 by 8 x squared. If we put the upper limit, that will be 36 minus 16, 36 minus 16 minus 1 by 24, 1 by 24. If we put the upper limit, that will give you 6 cube. So value of 6 cube is 216 minus 4 cube, that is, let me check it once again, So ultimately, if I simplify that, what will get? 1/3 plus 12/8, 12/8. Here we are getting 36 minus 16, that is 20. 20 into 3, that will be 60/8 minus 1/24. 216 minus 64. So 24 will be the LCM. 8 plus 36 plus 180 minus 152. So ultimately, what you're getting? 8 plus 36 plus 180 minus 152. Two by 24, that is 1/3. Sorry, 1/3, 3. So that's the mean of the distribution, mean of capital X. Now find the variance of capital X. So what will be V of capital X? Please try to find that V of capital X. So V of X, the variance of X, what do you know? Expectation of X squared minus whole squared. So expectation of X squared, again that will be minus infinity to infinity X squared into Fx dx minus 3 squared, that will be 9. Now that if we put the structure, we will get 0 to 2 first. 0 to 2 x squared into 1/8 x dx plus 2 to 4 x squared into 1/4 dx plus 4 to 6 x squared 3/4 minus 1/8 into x dx minus 9. Now complete the integration. If we complete the integration, 1/8 x to the power 4/4, 0 to 2, plus 1/4, x cubed by 3, 2 to 4, plus 3 by 4, x cubed by 3, minus 1 by 8, x to the power 4 by 4, 4 to 6, minus 9. So you please put the limits and try to simplify this. I'm not simplifying this, I'm leaving that for you. Next, we'll discuss about some standard distributions. So some special distributions. Some special distributions. So first we'll see discrete distribution. First, number one, we'll see binomial distribution. Binomial distribution. So what is a binomial distribution? So first see the suppose we are having an random experiment. E is the random experiment. The random experiment, the outcome of the random experiment are only two possibilities are there. This is the sample space. One is success, another is failure. Okay. So the experiment is such that the sample space of the experiment has only two possibilities. One possibility we are considering that possibility as success, other one is failure, or in other words, the sample space of the experiment consists of two events, either the event A or the event A complement. Either the event A will occur or the event A complement will occur. Only two possibilities are there. Suppose probability of A, this is small p, so probability of A complement, what will be probability of complement? 1 minus p, we are naming that as q. So what we are getting? P plus q equal to 1. Probability of A is equal to small p, probability of A complement is equal to q. The event space of the sample space consists of only two possibilities, either the event A or the event A complement. The probability of A is equal to small p and probability of A complement is equal to small q, that is 1 minus p. And we repeat the experiment. We repeat the experiment E n times independently. Repeat the experiment n times independently. Okay. And also we'll assume that in each repetition of the experiment, probability of A is remaining constant, that is small p is remaining constant. Okay, in probability of occurrence of the event A in the first experiment is same as the probability of occurrence of A in the second experiment, and so on. Okay? Repeat the experiment n times independently, and we are defining capital X as capital X is equal to the number of times the event A has capital X is equal to the number of times the event A has occurred. Okay, so what are the possible values of X? X can take the values suppose in number of times the event A has occurred. Now, how many times we are performing the experiment? We are performing the experiment n times. Suppose in all the repetitions we are getting the event A complement. So in that case, what will get? X will take the value 0. So X can take the values 0, 1, 2, and similarly in all the repetitions we are getting the getting the event A. So X can take on the values 0, 1, 2 up to N. See, in that case X is known as binomial random variable. Binomial random variable, and what will be the probability mass function here? P of I, this is equal to probability X is equal to I. Probability X equal to I means I times we are getting A. So that is NCI P to the power I 1 minus P whole to the power N minus I, and I will take the value 0, 1, 2 up to N. So this is the probability law in binomial distribution. Now look at this. In this distribution, the two parameters what we have used here, N and P. So sometimes this is known as binomial. So X is known as binomial NP distribution. What is N? N is the number of repetition of the experiment, and PP is the probability of the event A. So that's a binomial distribution. So what is binomial distribution, or how we can use binomial distribution? Suppose we are performing an experiment such that the event space of the experiment has only two possibilities, either the occurrence of the event A or the occurrence of the event B. Only two possibilities are there. Suppose the probability of occurring the event A is small p, so what will be the probability of occurring the event A complement? That will be 1 minus p. And we are repeating the experiment n times independently, and we are
also assuming then that in each repetition small p is remaining constant. Small p is remaining constant. Okay. And x we are defining as number of times the event A has occurred. Then x will be called a binomial distribution, or x will follow binomial distribution taking the values 0, 1, 2 up to n, where the probability law is governed by probability x is equal to I. Probability x equal to I means the probability that I times the event A has occurred. This is given by nci p to the power I 1 minus p whole to the power n minus I. I takes the values 0, 1, 2 up to n. Okay. So here the parameters are n and p. So in that case, sometimes we call that x follows binomial np distribution. X follows binomial np distribution. X follows binomial np distribution. B stands for binomial. X follows binomial distribution. Now remember, it's in binomial np distribution, if x is, if x follows binomial distribution, with parameters n and p, then if x follows binomial distribution with parameters n and p, then expectation of x, this will be n into p, and variance of x is equal to np into 1 minus p. Remember this result. Okay, the question may be asked from this. If suppose x follows binomial 6, 1 by 3 distribution, that is n is equal to 6 and p is equal to 1 by 3, what will be the expectation of x? Expectation of x will be n into p, that is 6 into 1 by 3, that will be 2. What will be the variance of x? Variance of x will be 6 into 1 by 3 into 2 by 3. So that will give you four by three. Okay, so we'll solve some problems related to binomial distribution in the next class, and also